Hi, it's Kevin LeBates here, and video 3 in a series on decentralized autonomous organizations, or DAOs. And today, I thought I would talk about voting systems and problems with voting systems. Because if you're going to have a smart contract that controls digital assets, and that has a voting system attached to it that allow its members to decide what should happen with those assets, you are going to need a voting system. And here, DAOs connect directly into traditional political science. Voting systems have been studied and implemented extensively over the last few hundred years, and what we have found out in traditional democracies is that all voting systems have flaws. And usually the problem is either one of voter participation and the community actually getting what it wants, and the second problem is one of complexity. So, looking at the simplest possible scheme that can be implemented in a DAO for voting, well, that would be the quorum voting system, whereby you have a threshold, and if that number of voting token holders vote for the proposal or more, then the proposal passes, otherwise it fails. Now, the problem with quorum voting is that you have to pick that quorum amount just right. If you set the quorum too high, then you end up with a paralyzed DAO. No proposals ever get passed because you can never get enough votes to pass them, and the whole purpose of the DAO is defeated. Who wants a smart contract sitting there on top of a vast hoard of assets, never ever spending them? However, if you set the quorum level too low, then you run the risk that a whale can take control, that there will be one party who has enough tokens to ensure that all or pretty much all of their proposals pass, and that converts the DAO into what is effectively a private wallet for that whale. Now, these problems occur in traditional democracies too, for example, in first-past-the-post systems or quorum voting in the UK and in the United States. You end up with tactical voting, where people don't vote for what they believe in, they vote against something that they find distasteful. And you see this in DAOs as well, where the voting system means that you end up with everybody in the community unhappy, but they all logically vote the way that they have because they're trying to reduce the chances of something they don't want to happen actually happening, rather than voting for the things that they want to happen. Now, these kind of problems can be overcome with more sophisticated voting systems, but more sophisticated voting systems come at a price, and that price is usually complexity. It's already hard enough to ensure voter turnout in normal democracies, and the same applies to DAOs, and when you make the voting system more complicated in order to make it more fair, you end up losing voters because people just think, I can't work out what is going on here, I'll just sit this one out. Now, DAOs have an extra advantage that democratic voting systems in countries don't, which is they can actually bolt on financial incentive systems in order to encourage people to vote. And here, for example, there's something called, I think, holographic consensus, where people actually don't just vote for things or against things for the DAO. They also bet on what the outcome will be with the second token. And depending on how they bet and what the actual outcome is, some of the participants in the system actually get a financial reward. And this is a kind of gamification of the voting system in order to ensure more participation. But as you can imagine, it also becomes more complicated because now you don't just have one token for voting, you have two, one for voting and one for gambling on the outcomes of the votes. Now, I could probably talk for half an hour on the various voting systems, and I'm not a voting expert. You should really go to somebody who has studied political science in order to truly get some depth and insight into these issues. But they are very interesting, certainly from a mathematical perspective. So that's today's video on DAOs and votings. And as you can see, it's gone on a bit longer than the other two videos. In the next video, I'm going to be talking about what it is that DAOs can actually do, because they can do a lot more than just sit on funds and then decide to send them to a particular wallet. That's it for today. See you in the next video soon. Bye for now.